Welcome back, Bourbon Barkeep, Curtis.
No, great to be here.
We got a new bottle.
That's right, the first 2024.
Yeah.
Pretty sweet.
Ultra excited for this one because we haven't technically used our new scoring system for Whiskey of the Year.
Mm-hmm.
So come January, this could be Whiskey of the Year
this
already.
This will be our first submission, yeah.
So we have the Larceny A-Batch 124 coming in at 124 proof .2. Want to make sure we gave all the credit.
And that A124 is A-Batch January of 2024 for those that just think that's some random assortment of numbers and letters. It's actually does mean something.
Which 8 months ago, I was that guy.
Uh-huh.
I had no idea.
Same.
People were asking me. I would just ask for the B-Batch.
Sure.
I didn't know what the numbers were. So they do mean something.
Right.
So the more you know, you're welcome. So what we kind of decided to do was... we kicked around, do we want to do A versus A, which we were kind of like, outside of the first initial, what do they have in common?
Sure, yeah.
B won the Larceny blind for us, so we were like, well, do we compare A versus the best?
Sure.
Made a little more sense, but then we kind of thought about the ratings were everywhere.
Right.
Because Minnick had C, no, A then C in his top 100, Breaking Bourbon had B. So they were all over the place.
Right.
So you came up with the genius idea of, well, why don't we just see if they improved?
Right. So we are comparing the A124, which is the latest release, to their previous latest release, which is 923, correct? So September of 2023.
Correct. And this is only 2 points, two proofs.
So 1%.
A whole 1% higher. So we're within the ballpark.
Very similar, yeah.
They're the same age, same mash bill, so this should be just a kind of a straightforward. So in our glasses here, we have A in the Bourbon Barkeep Glencairn.
Yes.
I know you'll probably mark them, but just in case people can actually see.
Right. We have no skin in the game, so we were kind of like, why do a blind? But yeah, so we neglected to do a blind this time, so we do know that the A124 is in those logoed Glencairns.
Well, we were even talking, I mean, the Elijah Craig, the C-Batch had so much hype.
It was... I don't want to be biased or swayed.
Larceny, which we've talked about in previous episodes, just doesn't have the marketing, for lack of a better word, to kind of
which
have
is
that
interesting.
Hype.
Yeah.
I feel like we really enjoyed all of them last year, so we'll kind of see what 2024 has in store for the Larceny Barrel Proof.
Sweet. Without further ado, man.
Yes. Do we do C first? Do we do C then A or A then C?
Let's start with last year's. Good call. Good call. Good catch.
Does it matter?
No. But okay. I like the... Usually your second idea is better, you know?
That's true.
But then there's also the go with your gut people.
I suck at going with my gut.
Uh-huh.
As you know. Mm-hmm. You've seen many times. All right. So C batch.
C, yep.
Of 2023.
Mm-hmm. To you, man. To you guys.
You.
Thanks for coming back. If you,
to you all.
Have been revisiting the channel, and welcome to all those who are meeting us for the first time. We ramble quite a bit.
Yeah.
I try to cut some.
It's
don't cut
there.
All of it. Yeah.
It's still there.
Don't cut all of it.
Some things I'm not proud of.
Mm-hmm.
Get a little bit more char this time. I get a little more getting underneath the caramel, if you will.
Yeah.
I get kind of a little bit more of a stewed peach. Like it's kind of started to open up a bit more to
mm-hmm.
it.
You remember last time it was like very caramel brown sugar, like just those kind of deep classic notes. And now I feel like there's a little more fruitiness to it. I don't know if there's... A little more cinnamon than last time. I'm getting quite a bit of cinnamon here, like that stewed peach, like that kind of peach pie almost.
Yep, yeah. That's what I'm going for. And then there's still, feel free to sip. I'll ramble a bit. The nose is fantastic. The nuttiness is a little bit there, but you do have a little bit more like a caramel nut. Like it's the nut is wrapped in caramel.
Sure. What's that candy bar? It's just basically caramel peanuts covered in chocolate.
It's Payday?
I think that's what I'm thinking of, yeah.
It's a lot of peanuts.
It's kind of like a Payday.
It does have a nice kind of zing to it, to where it dances on the tongue. Some people, I wouldn't call it like overly hot, but it definitely, nice little buzz on the tongue. I like it. That's nice.
Yeah.
Ultimately, people are here for the A.
Sure.
All right.
Ooh.
Let's coat that glass a bit.
I get a little bit of apple.
Yeah.
Like a dark red apple. not a Granny Smith, but what do you call that? Dark red apple? There's a word for it.
Red.
No, that's not what I'm looking for. Like I could have pulled that out myself. No, there's like a name for like that deep red apple.
Like the one that you give your teacher?
Yeah.
Red Delicious.
Is that really what it's called?
That's generally what it's called because I worked in produce.
That's kind of a letdown.
Yeah, sorry. It was also my stripper's name. Red Delicious.
With two D's on the red, right?
Absolutely.
Of course, like a red Zapple Ale.
And two E's in Delicious.
D.
Mm-hmm. Got to enunciate that one. Mm-hmm. All right, so back. So I would go, I'll see your Red Delicious. I do get kind of a nice milk chocolate on this one.
Ooh, okay. It's definitely a little sweeter.
Yeah. Yeah, this one still went a bit darker. This one, a little more vibrant.
Mm-hmm. Good word.
I feel like we actually said the last A batch was a little lighter green apple-y.
That was a sour apple, yeah. It got you kind of back here. I remember that.
Yeah.
So they took a little bit of sour off this.
The more this has kind of sat here and maybe warmed up in my hand, the more it's just kind of Snickers in the glass at this point.
Mm-hmm.
Like I've almost lost the apple, and now we're at this peanut, caramel, maybe a touch of nougat, but definitely a milk chocolate coming through now.
I was waiting on you to say nougat. Ooh. That has much more of a tingle.
This one, it just lingers. Like mm-hmm. It's still kind of on the sides of the tongue. Sure. It does a great job of just kind of coating it. Pretty viscous. Like it.
Mm-hmm.
My tongue is dry, but my mouth is watering.
I definitely get more of that, like kind of Snickers bar, like that milk chocolate peanut still there.
Yeah, and then you come back and revisit that nose. That Snickers is even more amplified,
mm-hmm.
but you get a little more oak on this one. I feel like maybe a touch more char,
mm-hmm.
in a good way.
It's pretty good.
Yeah, it's very different. Like I wasn't really, I don't think I was expecting a repeat because A, B, and C were
mm-hmm.
noticeably different side by side.
I am kind of shocked at how different they are. They're kind of other ends of the spectrum. I know they're similar proof, similar age, but like for being barrel proof bourbons, they're very, very different.
Very different. Wow. Jolly Green, what was it? The
Jolly Rancher?
Thank you.
Yeah, sure.
I really enjoy this one. Like it mm-hmm. comes in with a Snickers and it transforms into a green mm-hmm. Jolly Rancher. So the Red Delicious is kind of gone, but
yeah,
sits on the tongue, not a long, hot finish, but we've talked before to where I've kind of been saving these Larceny Barrel Proofs because we're big cigar guys. I've kind of been saving these for this May, August kind of cigar weather to mm-hmm. where you kind of want something to stand up to the smoke, but ultimately not overpower you and make you sweat and make sure. you pass out. All right, so which one do you like more?
Honestly, it's really tough because they're both really good. I think I would probably lean C923. I think I would lean last year.
The C is very good, especially revisiting it. Mm-hmm. It is more oily.
Mm-hmm.
So a little bit more viscous, but ultimately you know it just coats your tongue, where the A, slightly less thick, if you will, entering the mouth hole.
Mm-hmm. The what?
Mouth hole, right here.
You could have just gone mouth, man.
I would put it like this. The C batch is good enough, and I like how it feels in my mouth.
Mouth hole, yeah.
Your
pie hole.
So it's kind of more, hey, do you want kind of your brown sugar, your caramel,
yeah.
or mm-hmm. do you want this kind of Snickers mm-hmm. into this really fun fruit
sure.
Fruit extravaganza?
Really? Nice. Good for you. Yeah, it's definitely like, do you want your classic kind of desserty holiday type bourbon versus, you know, your kind of, as you used earlier, yeah. vibrant, fruitier bourbon. So it's really preference, but I do enjoy both quite a bit.
Yeah, C does go a little more traditional,
mm-hmm.
But I think that the A batch is definitely something
out there.
I'm
yeah.
happy that Larceny isn't sitting there saying, hey, we're just going to do this one path.
Mm-hmm. Keep putting out desserty, rich bourbons. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Very proud of them, if you will.
So yeah, so we want to score the 2024 version. This is our first submission into our Whiskey of the Year of 2024, which we will crown obviously at the end of 2024.
But I'm excited. I mean, I think this can do well.
Sure, I think it'll do really well. So yeah, we have two categories now. We started with five, and that was kind of jumbled, and they started to bleed into one another. So we kind of simplified it and separated into just two very simple categories, one being senses. And that is your all-encompassing nose, how it tastes, how it finishes, basically the entirety of the bourbon. And then secondly, it's bang for the buck. So we want to know, one, how much does this bottle cost? How much do we love it compared to what it cost? What would we pay for it? All that stuff.
Does it punch above its weight?
Sure.
As well?
If it's a $40 bottle that we're like, I'd pay $100 for that. Yep. It's going to score obviously really well.
Yep.
This is on a scale of 0 to 100. I'll flash the categories on the screen. We have eight different categories that it could technically fall into, depending on what we, you know, decide to score it, whether it be a 50. For example, that would be a highly average bourbon, obviously, being 50 smack dab in the middle.
Yep, yep.
So.
Well, I'm trying to ramp myself up that this is a great bourbon, and I cannot get there.
Right.
When I sip it, I feel like.
I'm on the same page.
This is the good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to go because I kind of want it to get to great. I'm going to go 78.
Okay.
So a high, good stuff.
Yeah, sure. I'm going to go 75. I think it's smack dab in the middle. It's a really good bourbon. Like you said, I'm not willing to like put it in that kind of upper echelon of stuff that we've tried since this channel started. Like we've tried some really, really good stuff, and I don't think it's on that, you know, tier one Patrick Mahomes type level bourbon.
Whoa.
Had to slide my guy in there, obviously.
It's more of a Baker Mayfield bourbon.
As a KC native. Yeah, this is like a Justin Herbert bourbon. It's just like a really, really good quarterback.
Absolute cannon.
Sure, yeah. But yeah, so I'm going to go 75 for senses. And then for bang for the buck, MSRP was 65? 60?
70.
70, okay, 70. I would probably pay more than that for that bottle. I would probably pay $80 for that bourbon. So I'm going to go 60.
That's fair.
Yeah.
Yes, I think this being $10 cheaper than Elijah Craig, I think in terms of functionality from what I'm looking for when it comes to, hey, I can have a barrel proof bourbon and may with my cigar to where I can't say that about a lot of other bourbons.
Mm-hmm.
I'm probably going to go 70.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah. I mean, it's a 6 to 8 year old bourbon.
So yeah, you'd pay quite a bit more than what you paid for it then, if that's what you're.
I would pay, we said this was 70, 85.
Okay, yeah, so you'd go a little higher than I would, but yeah, like still acknowledge that, like that's priced really, really well for what you're getting.
Yes, priced very well. Mm-hmm. I would go a little higher for Elijah Craig if need be. I think I'm kind of bracing myself for that inflation as well.
Those are going to be $100 this year, I can feel it.
So yeah, I think it's a good value in the barrel proof world.
Mm-hmm.
Agreed. One thing I will say is shout out to Leewood Wine and Spirits for hooking us up with the A124.
Yeah.
I have not been able to find it, so they threw us a bone.
Mm-hmm.
So shout out to them if you're in the Kansas City area. Beautiful store, very clean.
Mm-hmm. Leewood, nice area. That's what they say.
Yes, it's out of my price range, as I would say.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if it's out of yours, then it's out of mine. But yeah, so we will upload those scores into our sheet, if you will. And that, like I said, is our first submission in 2024. So currently the leader in the clubhouse.
Number one.
Yeah.
Number one.
The leader in the clubhouse with one player finishing 18 holes. So, yeah. So, tying up some loose ends, some odds and ends, all the different, you know, figures of speech.
Let's get the stuff out of the way.
Yeah.
Like, subscribe. Mm-hmm. Appreciate you guys coming back.
Yeah.
To the people that are new, as you said, welcome. Sometimes it gets weird. And
we ramble. Like I said, I cut most of it. I do the editing, and it's basically my discretion as to, like, what to keep.
Yeah.
And there are some times where I'm editing, I'm just tired, and I just leave it in.
Yeah.
So it's really a surprise for you on Friday mornings when you watched like what I ended up leaving in. But yeah, as a Patreon, we have a Patreon that I've been throwing bets into. If you've been here before, you kind of know the deal there. So we have Super Bowl coming up. So I'm going to have probably quite a few Super Bowl plays here trickling in over the next week and a half.
As you should. You got a little juice behind you.
For sure. Yeah. Like, as I've said before, Kansas City native. So please don't hate me for being a Chiefs fan. I have been a Chiefs fan since I was little. I did endure the years with Brody Croyle and Tyler Thigpen as our quarterbacks. So now I really do get to enjoy Patrick Mahomes as someone who suffered through those 3-13, 2-14 seasons.
Yay.
But yeah, really, really soaking it in and enjoying it for sure.
I'll bet you are.
Mm-hmm. But other than that, guys, to you,
thanks, man.
To Leawood.
To
maybe one day I'll live there.
Not the whole city, just Leawood Wine and Spirits.
No, just to Leawood.
Just.
If you're living in Leawood and you see this, let us know. Let me know what you did right.
If you're in Leawood and you see this, sign up for our Patreons, you rich.